Hello and welcome to Game 3 of the Social Media Showdown on Rugby League Live 4 between Oliver from Rugby League, in my opinion, and myself, Mrluke Sports. Now, just before I give away some spoilers, go back and watch Game 1 and 2. Now that's out of the way, I can talk about the previous games. So in Game 1 and 2, I picked up the victory. Mrluke picked up the victory. The first game was quite convincing. The second, not so much. Oliver, much improved. Had a better team overall, in my opinion. Just played a lot better. And he ended up just losing at the death. I scored right at the end. Regan Campbell-Gillard, saving day for myself. But this is a new game. Oliver looking to avoid the clean sweep here against Insane in the YouTuber Showdown. I went 3-0 against him. Can I do the same against Oliver? We'll find out very, very soon. But before we get into our lineups, which is just going to be in a moment, I'm just going to throw it over to Oliver. He's going to give his pre-game thoughts.
Heading into Game 3 is probably the team that I believe on paper is the weakest, but has the most to prove. I'm expecting big things out of these guys, the likes of Kalen Ponga in the centres. Anthony Don's been given a lot of responsibility with the captaincy. The former West Tigers partnership, Mitchell Moses and Luke Brooks, will be looking to prove themselves. Blake Austin at hooker, and the likes of the Zach Hardacre, I'm really excited to see play. So I'm a little bit confident for this one.
So Oliver, just as expected, very motivated to avoid the clean sweep there. But let's take a look at his lineups on the screen. All right, now we have Lachlan Coote at fullback. On the wings, we have Anthony Don and Dallin Watene-Zelezniak. In the centres, we have Zach Hardacre and Kalen Ponga. The halves are Luke Brooks and Mitchell Moses. Mitchell Moses at 5'8", actually. And then the props are Paul Vaughan and Jeremiah Hargraves with Blake Austin, an interesting hooker there. Not a position he's relatively known at, however, he's a great utility, so I'm sure he can do a pretty good job there, especially on Rugby League Live 4. Then we have a back row of Cohen Hess, Wade Graham, and Tevita Pangai Jr. Quite a strong back row in real life. We'll find out whether they're as strong on the game. Then the bench is Blake Green, Jared Wallace, Viliami Kikau, and Akawala. I don't really know too much about him. I'm not sure what his rating would be on Rugby League Live 4. I would assume not that high. As you're probably thinking, why is Kikau on the bench? Once again, Rugby League Live 4. When it came out, he was kind of a fringe player, I think. So his rating is not the best. So that kind of explains Oliver's team in terms of why he's got Kikau on the bench and not in the starting side. But yeah, that is his lineup. Let's move on to Mrluke's lineup. So here's my lineup. At fullback, we have Tom Trbojevic. On the wings, we have Val Holmes and we have Darius Boyd. The centers are Will Chambers and Dan Gagai. We have a halves combination of Cameron Munster and Mitchell Pearce. A front row of Andrew Fifita, Josh Hodgson, and Jesse Bromwich. Then a back row of Luke Lewis, Toru Harris, and Sam Burgess. The bench is Mitchell Orbison, Nelson Asofa-Solomona, Taki Yaho, and Jordan McLean. I think that is a very, very strong side. I think that is the second strongest side that I've fielded in any of these games. In fact, I meant to field this side in Game 2. I've mentioned that a billion times now. I'm not going to mention it again. But that back row is quite good. Lewis, Harris, Burgess. Burgess really carrying that one. Front row for Fifita and Bromwich. And Hodgson is one of the better hookers on this game. But that halves combination, Munster and Pearce, it seems perfect for Rugby League Live 4. Then that back line is very, very strong as well. Darius Boyd, very good rated on this game. Tom Trbojevic, pretty good rated. Val Holmes, great in this game. Chambers, Gagai, it is a strong back line. But that's both of the lineups. Now it's time to look at the game itself. Let's get into the game. Here we go, fellas. Game 3. Here we go. You've already seen the lineups. Now we're seeing the players run out. It is Oliver's team. Rugby League, in my opinion, team, but running out first. Once again, for the third time, playing in the World All-Stars jersey. Actually, not a bad jersey. Obviously, the All-Stars concept has changed, but hey, that jersey is quite nice. You got the star of all of the countries. But here is Mrluke's team running out. Sam Burgess leading them out. He is the captain for this game. It is kind of expected. Sam Burgess, what a player. Great leader, exactly who you want in your lineup, and that's why Mrluke selected him for those jerseys, the yellow and black. This is the third jersey that Mrluke has used. He used a different jersey every time, so that is quite interesting. The first one, obviously, there was a kick clash, two white jerseys going up against each other, but after that, it's been smooth sailing. So Zach Hardacre, an interesting one, playing in the centers today for Oliver. He is getting the game underway. He's going to be the goal kicker. Obviously, we've seen him in the NRL, but we haven't really seen the best of Zach Hardacre, in my opinion. I think he actually got Man of Steel in the Super League. So he is capable, and here is the game. Is Zach Hardacre going to be capable of something special in this game? We will find out. And that is a great start. Darius Boyd takes the kick return, takes the kick off, immediately makes a break. This has happened a lot on this game. Lots of line breaks from the kickoff, but can Mrluke strike early? He's got the offload away. That is a brilliant offload. Luke Lewis is tackled. He's wrapped up by Lockie Coote there. Great tackle there by Oliver. The great play from Mrluke. This is a phenomenal start, although that is not great. That's Josh Hodgson trying to run from dummy half and getting caught by the markers there. That's not fantastic. Then he's going quite sideways here. He does make a step. Tohu Harris gets through the gap and throws a terrible offload there. That is absolutely shocking there from Mrluke. Oh, wow. What the hell? Oh, that is, if I've ever seen anything that represents Rugby Lab 4 perfectly, that is it. Oliver throws a random pass, throws a random offload after Mrluke throws an offload and gives the ball away. But he throws it and then the game glitches out, sends it for a line dropout. So Mrluke looking to take advantage of Rugby Lab 4's downfall. Now, this game is obviously a pretty solid game, Rugby Lab 4, but it definitely has... it definitely does have its downfalls. Obviously, those glitches being one of them. We see Jesse Bromwich through the middle there. Can't get through any more players, though. Lockie Coote makes the tackle. Lachlan Coote making a mountain of work early on in the game, which could be quite bad for... Oh, there's the forward pass. I was just in the process of saying Lachlan Coote getting through a lot of work could be quite bad for his stamina long-term in this game, but... Oliver is let off there. A bad, bad error from Mrluke. A forward pass. I don't know if it was forward, but the referee has given it. Let's just trust the referee's decision. I don't know if you want to do that in real life, but we're going to do that on the game, that's for sure. Nothing else he can do, really. So Cameron Munster just takes a pretty simple hit up there. Oh, sorry, not Cameron Munster. He's on Mrluke's team, looking at the wrong team. Mitchell Moses takes a pretty simple hit up there. So I finally got it. I finally got the 5/8 right. There you go. My commentary, a little bit dusty. It's not the best to start off with, let's be honest. But Callum Ponga takes a run there. Actually, it's Callum Ponga in a dummy half. I feel like Rhea Warren getting all the names mixed up. Going sideways. This was a common theme for Oliver in the previous games. Going sideways and not really making any ground. You can see 4 meters gained. Honestly, it seems like a bit of a panic move from Oliver. And it's not really working well, but he is shifting it to the left. He throws an intercept. Oh my God, Dane Gagai. Millimeters away from going and scoring. Unfortunately, finds himself over the sideline. But that is very, very risky play from Oliver there. He cannot be doing that. That's a blown try there for Mrluke. He'll definitely be ruining that one. A lot of regret for him. Can he take him over the sideline? No, he can't. But Tenny Zalesniak stays in field. Callum Ponga jumping into dummy half there. Once again, going sideways. But this time, it's working out okay. He gets around the fullback too. Tommy Tavoyevich can't get him. Callum Ponga himself fullback. He finds himself in the centres this game. An interesting move. Going to the left. Oliver, can he score? That's a pretty poor ball there. But he is making great inroads. Third tackle, 11 minutes into this game. What can he do? He's gone back through the middle. Pretty simple player there. Bit of a settler. Although he's taken runs with his halves. Mitchell Moses, not the one you want to have taking just simple hit-ups. Paul Vaughan, that's more like it. That's what you want as to why he just palmed off a player. Great run from Paul Vaughan. Tetsama for a fifth tackle option. What are they going to do? He's trying to slot a field goal like he did in game two. What is Oliver doing, man? First it was Matt Scott in game two. This time he's trying to take it with Mitchell Moses. At least that makes a bit more sense in terms of the player taking it. But he's given away a penalty. Mitchell Pearce has not found touch. Callum Ponga catches it, rubbers it out of instinct when you're just spamming the hell out of the controller to just grub it. Thankfully, my player has come across and kicked it out because we were in serious danger. Grubbers, super effective on this game. I feel like I've scored quite a few grubbers myself throughout this series. So we all know how overpowered they are in Rugby League Live 4. So the fact that Gagai got his foot to it, I think that really, really saved Mrluke there. But he's not going to be able to save right now. Callum Ponga goes through. Couldn't score before, but does score right now. It opens the scoring there for Oliver. That is brilliant play from Callum Ponga. Too easy, though. Too easy. That Mrluke really needs to steady up his defense there because that was super, super easy. It was just simply pass it to Ponga and step through and score. Too much pace for Dan Gagai, I believe it was, who missed the tackle. He did save Mrluke earlier by kicking the ball out, but that's a bad error. Mitchell Pearce not finding touch. Terrible stuff there from Mrluke. You get given a penalty in that field position, you got to capitalize on it. And Oliver, he actually did capitalize on it. He capitalized on his opportunity. I feel like that is something he's kind of been lacking in the previous games as to why he is down 2-0 to Mrluke. But he's definitely taken his chance there. Great start from Oliver. He actually got first try scorer in game two as well. So I'd assume Mrluke would not be too worried about it. It's not exactly unfamiliar territory, but it's not the start you want, especially considering some of the opportunities Luke has had. Drawing and passing here, a little bit too early. Hargraves gets picked up. Great run from Oliver. He's definitely on the front foot here. He's got all the momentum in the ball. Blake Austin taking a run. We know how nippy, we know how speedy he is. Can't get through the opposition though. Great tackle from Mrluke. That's what I was talking about. Needs to shore up that defense. He's not really doing so though. Fourth tackle, 17 minutes in. Going to the left, a really bit of a nothing play, but Callum Ponga nearly turns it into something. There's an offload. Can he get another one? No, he can't. Can't get the second offload. That would have been dangerous if they could. There was an unmarked winger out there. Potentially could have been a try. Now he's going for another field goal. What is Oliver doing? He's just taking field goals every chance he can. I suppose when time's tough, you gotta do what you gotta do. But he's been taking field goals and he's 0 from 2 here. Two charge downs from two field goal attempts. Good stuff from Mrluke for realizing and sort of being desperate and going for it. But yeah, Oliver really has come up with a different fifth tackle play because it's not really working at this point. But it is 6-0 to Oliver though, so he can't really complain too much. There's an offload, a risky offload. Pretty poor offload. Josh Hodgson is wrapped up very, very easily. Dan Gagai jumping into dummy half here. And he gets a pass. Will Chambers with a lot of space there. Will Chambers is going to score in the corner. We've gone center to center there. Not exactly something you see every day in rugby league. Maybe back in the day you would, but not so much in 2020. But Dan Gagai takes it to the line, throws a pass. Anthony Don going for the intercept there. Misses it. Oliver just got suckered in. When I play career mode, this is something that I tend to do a lot. Come out, you expect them to take intercepts. In previous games, they would have taken the intercept. Instead, they just run straight past it, and Mulchamers had an open run to the try line, and Valentine Holmes then converts the extra. So it is 6-0. Finally, I've worked out goal kicking on this game. So that's going to be good in the long run for me in this game, I would imagine. So 6-0, 22 minutes in. I think it is a deserved scoreline at the moment. Oliver's been pretty good, but I feel like Mrluke's had his chances as well. So 6-0, I feel like it's pretty fitting at this point. But Mrluke looking to strike. That's a great little pass there. Back through the middle. Dane Gagai goes around the fullback, goes straight around him. Oh, and another glitch. And Will Chambers ends up on the ball for the second time. Will Chambers is the beneficiary of a little bit of screwy on rugby league life 4. And Oliver finds himself down by 4 points within a matter of minutes. That is so disappointing for Oliver. But good stuff for Mrluke though. Creating the line break. Sometimes you got to create your own luck. And obviously did get quite lucky. Tohu Harris with a nice pass there to Dane Gagai. Takes it straight around Lockie Coote. Obviously Lockie Coote, pretty decent fullback, pretty good defender in real life, but he just got absolutely shown up there by Dane Gagai. But Will Chambers, the beneficiary of all the screwery, and he scores his second try of the game. Will Chambers, pretty decent center, well, pretty is an exceptional center in his time. I wouldn't exactly think he had scored a lot of doubles. I don't know. I wouldn't say he's like a try-scoring machine for a centre, but he's come up with the goods in this game. And Mrluke now finds himself up 12-6. This is a pretty good turnaround from Mrluke. Meanwhile, look, I do know, I'm very well aware, been a lot of luck in this, but you just got to take your luck. And here we go. Valentine Holmes making a break from the kickoff. This is what I was talking about at the start of the game. Lots of line breaks from the kickoff. Valentine Holmes this time. Saw Darius Boyd making one earlier. So both wingers making a few line breaks there. Just a matter of finishing the opportunities. They haven't done so as of yet. But Tom Trbojevic takes a run from dummy half. Doesn't really do too much with it there. But Josh Hodgson jumps in the dummy half. Can he do something with it? Takes a step there. Goes around him. Can't get around Lachlan Coote. Brilliant tackle from Lachlan Coote. But Josh Hodgson, great little run there. He would expect that sort of stuff from Damien Cook and such, but not from him, and all the good work, he's just completely undone. Terrible play there. I knew the play that Mrluke was going for. It was the inside pass, kind of similar to what the Storm did with Slater, Kronk and Smith, but it just hasn't really worked out. I suppose you do need those three for it to really work and be effective. So Oliver needs to take advantage of this, needs to get a try before halftime. Nearly an intercept of his own. Mrluke reading that quite well. Taking it to the line, looking for the short ball. It does work sometimes, but when it doesn't, it definitely doesn't. Kalen Ponga has been damaging on that left-hand side for Oliver. Stepping another player there. Gagai is having a mare against him. Oh, and there, speaking of mares, that is one of them. Oliver coming up with an error there. That is very, very poor. So Mrluke looking to take advantage of it just before halftime. Definitely needs to take advantage of it. If he can score another try here, I feel like that might kill off the game. Great little short ball, Luke Lewis. Hitting the hole there is wrapped up though, 30 meters out. Mitchell Pearce taking it to the line. All he had to do was keep running. He throws the pass though. Sammy Burgess can't get the offload. I feel like the offload was there, but Mr. Luke should go to the right. He throws the cutout pass, gets the offload away. Darius Boyd is wrapped up a couple metres out from the line. Brilliant play from Mr. Luke. Great defence from Oliver. He is holding on within a whisker. And Jesse Brumage goes over and scores. That is brilliant play from Mr. Luke. Oliver quite unlucky in this game, but there was no luck involved about that one. Just too good there. Jesse Brumage goes over. Very unlucky for Mr. Luke to not score in the corner here. Nice little offload from Dan Gagai. Gets it to Darius Boyd, but he's wrapped up a few metres out. It was Wattenis at Lesniak. Came up with a pretty big tackle there. But just a big pass to Jesse Brumage. Once again, Oliver coming out of the line, looking for the intercept. And it hasn't happened. Like I said, I've done that quite a bit in rugby league life for myself. It just doesn't work on this game. If Oliver's going to be any chance of winning, he needs to stop doing that. Because it's just not going to work. It's not effective. And Valentine Holmes kicks the goal while I'm talking about that. So it's 18-6 to Mr. Luke. It was a 6-0 lead to Oliver. It's been an 18-point turnaround. And Mr. Luke finds himself up 18-6. This has been a pretty solid first half there. Not sure what Mr. Luke was doing there. And Josh Hodgson getting a little bit wayward there, sort of standing around. But Tommy Trbojevic jumps in, dummy half. Brilliant run. Tom Trbojevic beats the first player. If you say your fullback in the middle there, you definitely want to take a run with them on this game. So effective. Them up against the tired forwards. Jesse Brumage through the middle as well. Mr. Luke really attacking the middle. There's a tendency in Rugby League Life 4 to attack the edges, but Mr. Luke having a lot of success going straight down the middle here. Once again, Sam Burgess straight over the top of one player, but he is wrapped up. Now, what is Mr. Luke going to do? Is he going to take a field goal? Is he going to go for an extra try? If he scores another try, it's 100% game over. Oh, this look. Oh, that is a brilliant tackle. I was just going to say, this is looking very, very dangerous. Looking very reminiscent of the Will Chambers try, the first one where he came out of the line, but Oliver goes for the ankle tap or some sort. So I don't know if it was an automated one or if he intentionally did it, but Callum Ponga came up with the perfect play there as the ball sails over the sideline and Oliver survives. It's very unfortunate for Mr. Luke, but that's just how it goes sometimes. Oliver, a great defense there, holding on. That's exactly what he just needs to do. He needs to hold on till halftime. If he can even snag a little sneaky try for halftime, that'd be brilliant for him as well. It's not looking too likely here. Oh, I was going to say forward pass there, but that wasn't a forward pass. We have seen them given on this game. It does seem very random whether they give forward passes or not. There's a step there by Wattenis Lesnia. Great little run there. Dan Gagai, once again, having a lot of trouble on that wing. And Darius Boyd as well, for a matter of fact. But Callum Ponga, great run. Didn't need to throw the pass. I know, just instinct. You throw it because you think you're not going to break through the tackle. You're looking for the offload, and you end up making a line breaker. Mr. Luke gives away a penalty there. Not the best of decisions there. Probably should have just taken the tackle. And then probably would have only made one more tackle. And it would have been half time. Instead, he's going to have to defend here. Probably the last play of the first half. And Wattenis Lesniak takes a simple hit up. I suppose, in theory, not a bad thing to do. We've had a lot of success down that side. Gagai's been struggling. But they comfortably make the tackle and take us out to halftime. 18-6 at halftime. It has been a pretty solid game of football. Not too many errors. A lot of attacking plays. Lots of line breaks. See, 16 line breaks to Mr. Luke to 8 for Oliver. So Mr. Luke, in stats-wise, has been all over Rugby League, in my opinion. I suppose that is reflected with the scoreline there. But 6 out of 12 completions, definitely not good enough. And 8 from 11 from Oliver, not too bad for Rugby League Live 4 standards. But Mr. Luke definitely needs to pick it up in the second half, or there could be a comeback. But Mr. Luke himself did a comeback, and it all started with Callum Ponga getting Oliver to a lead. So Mr. Luke needed to make the comeback because Oliver had a fantastic start. A little bit of luck going Mr. Luke's way, but there's been a few little glitches in this game. This wasn't exactly a glitch, but a bit unlucky for Oliver. Will Chambers goes over and scores his first try of the game. Now we have Tohu Harris hitting Gagai with a nice little pass there. Takes it around Lachlan Coote. We have players chasing. Blake Austin, I believe, is the one who comes across there. And the ball ends up just ricocheting like 30, 40 metres across the field. It ends up in the hands of Will Chambers, I believe, on the full. Just ends up taking it very, very comfortably. Ends up scoring a try. Very unlucky, but I mean, end of the day, it was a line break to Mr. Luke after all, so maybe he would have scored later on, maybe he wouldn't have, but he's taken advantage of that. He scored his second try of the game. Will Chambers has got his second try of the game. Now he jumped to the third try. It's Mr. Luke once again, nearly scoring with Darius Boyd. Can't get the job done, but Jesse Brumage does, and Mr. Luke ends up with a 12-point lead at halftime. Brilliant game so far. Hopefully it continues in the second half. Speaking of the second half, let's get into it. So here we go. Second half, about to get underway. Valentine Holmes gets us going. We've seen a lot of line breaks starting off with the kickoffs. Can Oliver do it? He's going crossfield. Hasn't really had a lot of success going crossfield. Can he do it this time? Oh, that's looking good. That is looking very, very good. Delaware Tennis Lesniak beats every player, and they are going to score straight from the kickoff. That is the worst possible start for Mrluke. I feel like I've said that quite a lot in this series. Worst possible start for Mrluke as Oliver races away and scores and gets himself right back into this game immediately. The perfect start. Delaware Tennis Lesniak, great player. Obviously, I'm a Bulldogs fan. I love him at the Bulldogs. I don't love him right now, though. What a try. Goes crossfield here. Luke Brooks takes it, runs crossfield, throws a pass to Wade Graham. Bit of a ball player, but nothing really going on. But Dane Gagai once again getting step silly there. And then Tom Drewovich misses with Tennis Lesniak, and it's all she wrote. With Tennis Lesniak goes the distance. Great try from the former Penrith man as he scores for Oliver and gets him back into the game. Rugby League, in my opinion, are they going to make a comeback? Well, I certainly hope not as a commentator or as Mrluke here. But as the commentator, I want to see him. I want to see him make a comeback. I want to see him get back into this game. And Zach Hardacre, skip the goal. So that's exactly what they're doing. Can they make it two in a row, though? Can they score from the kickoff? Mrluke would be very, very nervous going into this one, but he doesn't even try. Takes a simple hit up. Luke Brooks, just a little bit more juice taken out of his tank. Mrluke, I won't mind that at all. But goes to the centre. Zach Hardacre, not exactly the same as the other centre and wingers. We saw Zlesniak have a really good run, but I don't expect Zach Hardacre to be doing that. But he's going sideways here. Anthony Don, I don't know what he's doing. He's looking for a gap, I guess, but Mrluke just kept chasing him across the field, wraps him up comfortably, and he is losing metres here. Once again, the pass to Ponga play, it's kind of effective there. It has been effective all game, to be fair to him. He's been going for it, and it's been working. But at some point, you got to assume it's not going to work. And there we go. A little bit of Rugby League Live 4 shithousery right there. Another glitch. Another sort of intercept attempt. I thought Mrluke was going to end up with the ball. Oliver, whoever reclaims it, and it was a the tackle count was restarted. Don't know if that was deserved by Oliver. Pretty poor set after points. Got himself right back into the game and almost as quickly lost himself the game. If that had been not six to go, I think he would have been in trouble. Doesn't matter. Valentine Holmes picks up the pass there. Big tackle from Mrluke, resulting in a turnover. Can they score and break open the game once again? And he's 18-12. Another try here to Mrluke. I feel like we'll just give him that little bit of comfortable. He's just making himself a little bit more comfortable in this game. 18-12. I'd say he'd be relatively comfortable at this point. But just going 12 points up definitely eases pressure a little bit. Great pass there. Goes through. Cameron Munster is wrapped up. Six to go as well. There's a six to go call that the Raiders didn't get. But Mrluke certainly does. And he hits Jesse Bromwich. Jesse Bromwich scores his second try of the game. What is going on here? It's the Will Chambers and Jesse Bromwich show. Scoring doubles. Jesse Bromwich, I don't know how many doubles he scored in his career, but it wouldn't be many. But he has scored it in the Rugby League Live 4 Showdown Game 3. Just once again, racing out of the line. I believe it was with Wade Graham. He raced out, tried to go for the intercept. And as we've seen two times previously, it doesn't work for the third time. So Oliver definitely needs to improve on that if he wants to be good at Rugby League Live 4 and wants a victory. But 24-12, pretty comfortable spot here for Mrluke. But Zach Hardacre gets the game underway again. Nearly kicks it dead. Nearly kicks it dead. Very, very unlucky for Mrluke. If the play's been like real life, they probably would have reached out and then caught it. And then it would have been a penalty. But, I mean, as we've seen from Mrluke, maybe penalties aren't the best thing. Last time they went for it, they didn't find touch. And then Oliver ended up capitalizing and scoring. So, oh, Luke Lewis is through the gap. The former winger center. He doesn't have the legs to go the distance. He is a bit older these days, obviously retired in real life, but on the game, he's still on it as to why he was eligible to play. Just a reminder, in case you haven't been watching all of the games, the reason we got these teams is we picked 60 people in a squad. They all had to be just one player. So if I picked Sam Burgess, Oliver couldn't pick Sam Burgess, we both couldn't have him. Once it was just a one and done, and once they've played in one of these games, they're also done as well. So players who played in game one can't back up and play in game two and three. That's why we had a 60-man squad. So that was just a clarification on the rules. But Tom Trbojevich needs to make this tackle on Wade Graham. He does so. Great run there from Wade Graham. Needs to hit the left. Doesn't. He doesn't hit the left. I don't know what Oliver's doing. He had numbers there on the left-hand side. Callum Ponga, though, I suppose if you're going to make a run, you better do it with him. But believe it or not, I think Callum Ponga's only like 83 rated on this game. So he is destroying Mrluke. However, ratings-wise on this game, not fantastic. Not one of the better players on this game. Darius Boyd, for context, I think is about 87, something like that. 87, 88. Or is he going over the sideline? I think he was. Definitely Mitchell Orbison just went over the sideline. Orbo, one of the nicest guys you'll ever meet from what everyone has said. But he definitely, that was not nice. He's gone over the sideline. He's given Oliver an opportunity here. And that just seems to be a common theme. Mrluke sort of can't capitalize on Oliver's mistakes. It seems weird considering he's up 24-12. But there was a bad offload there. And once again, finds himself running over the sideline. There was an incident earlier in the game where there was a ball hitting the ground. All he had to do is pick it up and run. Ends up over the sideline. This time, Orbison runs over the sideline. Not good stuff there for Mrluke, but so there's not too much you can do. When the camera rotates and it's all happening so quick, it's just going to happen sometimes. If you have time to think about it, you can stop running and that. But just in that instance, it all happened so fast. And I suppose nothing Mrluke really could have done. But Oliver hasn't really done anything with it. You can see 3 meters gain. That is pretty poor in this game. It is quite easy to make meters. And Oliver just not doing it. But he does go for a grubber here. Paul Vaughan. I don't know what's up with Oliver and forwards making good little kicking decisions there. Or good little kicks. It was Matt Scott in the previous game. This time it's Paul Vaughan with the grubber. Getting a repeat set. There was a touch from Mrluke. Couldn't hold the ball. And Oliver reclaimed the ball here. So can he score? A bit of luck for Oliver. Mrluke's had plenty of luck this game. So it is fitting for Oliver to do it. I thought he was going to go and score there. Blake Austin, 1-on-1 against a big forward. Actually, I think it was up against Tom Trbojevic. Maybe that explains it. But Blake Austin couldn't step his way through. I thought he was going to, though. And they can't go out to the wing. They're just throwing it to the wingers and hoping they can score. This is a little bit better. This is what they need to do. Pangai Jr. had the arm free. Could have got the offload away. Could have potentially scored. But it is floor tackle. Austin going sideways. Gets the offload away. Can they score? Paul Vaughan is held up. Thought he was going to fall over the line. It happens quite a lot from Eagle Life 4. But it is fifth tackle. Going to the line. Throws a grubber. Oh, they get the ball too. Anthony Don. Is he going to go over? No, he's not. It is handover. That is very, very good defense from Mrluke. Oliver, I'll be honest, didn't really offer too much in that. A lot of passing it, a lot of just one out and then trying to look for a step. It does happen a lot in Rugby League Life 4 though, so I can't blame him. We've seen how effective the stepping has been throughout this whole series for him, so it does make sense that he would keep doing it. That is a bad miss. Taki Aho ended up getting his head taken off there. Lachlan Koo just absolutely destroys him there. Big, big moment for Mrluke there. If he could have went through it and scored, it would have been game over. Oliver gives away the penalty though, so does give another opportunity. Sam Burgess goes up and makes a very, very good run, a big run. Probably gains about 50 metres or so, although that is followed up by a terrible play there. Terrible stuff there. What is Luke doing? All he had to do was take a few more hit-ups, kick a field goal. There you go. Game is over. But Oliver is back within a shot here. Can he score? Between his legs next. Scored one try. Is he going to score a second one? Yes, he is. This is very reminiscent of early in the game when he's run away and scored from the kickoff. This time he scored from a scrum. And now Oliver, all of a sudden, is back in the game. Mrluke would absolutely be kicking himself there. Had the perfect opportunity to wrap up this game. Instead, Oliver goes length of the field and scores a try with Dallin Watenis Lesniak. A lot of doubles in this game. Watenis Lesniak scoring a double. Bromwich, Will Chambers scoring doubles. This seems to be a common theme with this game. But Watenis Lesniak goes and scores another long-range try. So I suppose that's another common theme. Long-range tries to Watenis Lesniak. Long-range tries to Oliver as he gets himself back into the game. If he kicks this goal, which he needs to. He really needs to hit this goal. Zach Hardacre slots it straight over there. So it is now a six-point ball game. 13 minutes to go in this game. I'm not sure how long that is in real-life terms, but in terms of this game, 13 minutes to go. Well, under 13 minutes to go. So we're getting into the final 10 minutes coming up. So it's going to be a tense final 10 minutes, you would imagine. Mrluke, can he hold on? Can he score another try? Can Oliver equalize? Can he score a couple tries? We've seen in this game, if you score one try, there is a tendency to score a few quick tries. Mrluke's done it a few times. Oliver's done it a few times. We've seen him score from the kickoff. There is a forward pass there. I can't believe that was forward. I thought that was okay. Well, I thought personally that was sweet. The referee has given it. Earlier in the game, there's a few dubious calls in terms of forward passes in that weren't given. This time, maybe a bit of a square up. Let's just just go with it. Let's say that is a square up, and Mr. Luke has a prime opportunity to go ahead and kick a field goal here. Tom Drobojevic has gone around the players here. Is he going to score? Oh my god, there's an ankle tap, and he ends up getting brought down 5 meters out. I can't believe Tommy Drobojevic has been stopped there. I thought he was in for all money. Instead, they've thrown it out to Darius Boyd. Luke going for the bit of an Oliver play. They're throwing it out to the winger and seeing if he can get over. He couldn't. Mitchell Pearce finds Josh Hodgson. Josh Hodgson, plenty of space, and he goes over and scores. Finally, someone different. Josh Hodgson scores, and he wraps up the game for Mr. Luke. At least you would imagine, under 10 minutes ago, going back to a 12-point lead, you would imagine he was going to kick the goal. And just from next to the post, it's, you know, you could throw it over at this point. As Andrew Voss would say, you might be able to even heel it over, kick it with your heel. But Valentine Holmes kicks the goal. Great goal kicker in real life and on the game, and he slots that one. It's 30-18, and like I said, under 10 minutes to go. So I can't see Oliver coming back from this one. In real life, you probably go for a short kickoff. On this game, you can't really do it. It's not effective at all. So you just have to go long and hope that the opposition makes an error. So Mr. Luke needs to make an error, and to be honest, would not put it past him. Does make a lot of errors in the following set after scoring a try. Essentially, it's either you score a try or you make an error, and then Oliver gets back into the game. That seems to be the theme for Mr. Luke. So him completing this set is crucial, at least making good field position. Throws it out to the winger though, Valentine Holmes, and that's what I'm talking about. That's what I'm talking about. Poor play from Mr. Luke. Throws it out to Valentine Holmes. Panics a bit and throws an inside pass to nobody. And Oliver is back in the game here. Can he score a try? He's back in the game. He is running out of time very, very quickly. So Mr. Luke, all he has to do is make a few more tackles and it's essentially a game over. He's not going to have too much time. But he does find himself with the ball, 20 meters out, third tackle. He's probably going to score kind of now, but he looks to be sort of taking his time. He's palmed off a player there, found an offload. It's Paul Vaughan. Paul Vaughan's actually had a very, very good game. Done a nice little grubber before on the receiving end of that offload, but it doesn't look like Oliver doing too much. Can he get to the line? No, he can't. Very, very unlucky. That would have been so interesting if he had scored there. That would be a game-changing try. Instead, Oliver's dive for the line fractionally early, and he's ended up giving the ball away. There's a knock-on, and this time Mitchell Pearce actually kicks the ball out after there is a penalty. I believe it was held in the tackle, but that is a big let-off for Mr. Luke there. Once again, Oliver just not getting the luck when he needed it. I think that's all that separated these two. Maybe not so much in the first game, but in game 2 and 3, I feel like all that separated them was a bit of luck. Oliver needed some luck, didn't get it right there, and he ends up just diving fractionally short, giving the ball away, and instead of having an opportunity to tie up the game, he's now behind. There is a knock on there though. I believe he was looking for an offload was Mr. Luke. Oliver ends up with the ball, but if he does score here, it's going to be nothing but a consolation try. 30-18, Oliver, a great effort from himself there, but it's just fallen marginally short. Like I said, a little bit of luck went his way, and he might have got a victory here, but Mr. Luke has held on. 30-18, this is where the game is going to end. What a series. Hopefully you guys did enjoy it. Obviously, the NRL has been shut down, all sports have been shut down, so Mr. Luke here, I thought that I would bring together a series for you, and hopefully you did enjoy it. It's a three-match series, Red League Live 4, not the best of games, but it's the best I can do for at the moment. So hopefully it provides you with a little bit of entertainment, considering there's not much happening right now in the world. But Josh Hodgson picked up man of the match. Personally, I probably wouldn't have given it to him. Maybe Sam Burgess, someone. Will Chambers was very, very good. Tom Trbojevic was good. But yeah, you see tries to Jesse Bromwich, Will Chambers, and Hodgson. And then for Rugby League, in my opinion, Watene Selesniak, 2 long-range tries. Callum Ponga also scoring for him as well. We're going to be taking a look at the highlights for the second half, go through all of the tries. It starts off with the kickoff. Be able to see here, Valentine Holmes gets the second half underway. Mr. Luke just made some subs, some fresh changes. You're thinking, yep, ready to go. Instead, it is Oliver who strikes. Watene Selesniak steps, Gagai goes around Trbojevic. A little bit of a step himself there. And then he goes the rest of the way and does score a very, very nice try. Perfect start there for Oliver. Exactly what he needed. 18-6 down at halftime. It was not looking good. However, he scores that try. It's 18-12. It was looking all right until this happened. Jesse Bromwich goes over and scores his second try of the game. Very, very reminiscent of the first try he scored. So once again, just breaking open the game a little bit. Bit of breathing space for Mr. Luke. But it didn't last long. Dallin Watene Selesniak from a scrum. I believe there's a little bit of controversy as to what happened with the scrum. but they end up with the ball there, and Watene Zalesniak goes the distance. It all didn't matter though, as Mrluke ramped up the game here with Josh Hodgson. Just a simple pass, nearly scored earlier, but Josh Hodgson just goes over. That's the way he probably got man of the match. Lots of tackling, lots of run meters probably, and he scored a try. So he picks up a man of the match. Now I'm going to throw it over to Oliver. He's going to give his thoughts on the game and the series as a whole. So over to you, Oliver.
Just wasn't good enough. Really wasn't good enough. I'm disappointed. Plenty of chances that didn't go our way. Plenty of chances we didn't take an opportunity of. And it's so frustrating because I know I can beat him. I know I can beat Mrluke. I know he is the rugby league live four guy. But I know I can beat him. I can. And, you know, I'm determined to show you guys that I can beat Mrluke and that this game is against me. And the way I'm going to do that, I'm not actually going to verse Mrluke. I'm laying down a challenge to Mrluke right now. You think you're so good? Well, Luke, I don't even think you can beat the AI. Here is my challenge for you, if you're man enough. You let me select 17 players for you to play with. I'll create the team, you play as them, and you're going to be going up against the Australian Kangaroos. Accept my challenge and prove that you really are the best player at Rugby League Live 4.
So there we have it. Oliver obviously disappointed, but throwing down another challenge to Mrluke. Instead of playing himself, he is going to be picking a team of 17, and he's going to be making Mrluke play against the Kangaroos. So we're going to be able to see if Mrluke can get the job done against the Kangaroos. We've seen him get the job done against Oliver tonight. It's 3-0 to Mrluke in the Rugby League Live 4 social media showdown. Can he get the job done against the Kangaroos? Stay tuned. We're going to find out what team Oliver has picked in the coming weeks. But for now, this is the end of the social media showdown. Hopefully you did enjoy it. If you did, make sure you like and subscribe and all that sort of stuff. Check out Oliver's Facebook page. Check out my Facebook page. Check out all my social medias, Mrluke on YT and that sort of stuff. But yeah, hopefully you did enjoy it. A little bit of entertainment while everyone's in isolation. So yeah, that's all I really got to say. Thanks for watching, guys, and we'll see you for the next video, whatever that is. Bye, guys.